how to compare data in Excel files and find differences. Now, I always hear people say, just bump that file against this one, or bump those files together. Well, there's a lot of different ways that we can do this, and in this video, I'm going to show you three real-life examples, including how to find missing data between two files using XLOOKUP. Then we'll look at how to find differences between two reports using if formulas and then conditional formatting. And then finally, we'll learn how to detect duplicates in your data using Excel's built-in highlight duplicates feature. Let's take a look. In this first example, we've loaded work assignment data into our HR system. And I can see if I highlight column B where I have the employee ID numbers, and I look down at the count that's in my status bar down here, I can see that I've loaded 5,254 records. Now I wanted to make sure that I'm not missing any from the existing employees that might be in my database. So I ran a query of my employee list, and I can see if I click on that column of data with the employee ID numbers, my count is higher. So I want to find out the difference. I want to identify on this list which employees I'm missing work assignments for so that I can work on getting those loaded. So when I clicked on this tab, I selected column B and I clicked on the count down here. That will copy to my clipboard that count number. So I'm going to put that over here. I'm going to right click and paste. Now I'm going to click on column B again, and I'm going to click on the count on this tab, and I'm going to paste that up here and paste. So now I want to do a quick calculation and find out how many employees might be missing that work assignment. So I'm just going to say equals, we're going to say this count minus the count on the work assignment tab, and that's 29 employees who are missing. So I want to identify which 29 employees on this list might be missing that work assignment. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that, and I'm going to add a column. We're going to right-click on column C and insert, and then up here I'm going to title this missing work assignment. And I'm going to highlight this a different color. Now we're going to use XLOOKUP to compare these two files. So I'm going to type equals, and then I'm going to start typing XLOOKUP. I hit tab when it comes up, and then the open parentheses opens up, and I can select my first argument, which is the lookup value. And I'm going to use the employee ID number on both sheets as the lookup value. So all I have to do is select the employee ID number, the first one that I want to look up. Then I'm going to hit comma, and it will move to the next function in the argument, which is lookup array. And this is where I'm going to navigate to my work assignment file, and I want to look up that employee ID number over here in column B. So I'm just going to highlight column B. Now I'm going to hit comma, and now it asks, what do I want to return? So in this case, I just want to return the work assignment number or a number value if this exists on the other sheet. So I'm going to highlight column C, and then I'm going to close parentheses and hit enter. And so now, if I copy this down, so I'll select the cell that has the XLOOKUP formula, double click on my fill handle, and it will copy that all the way down. And so now, for every record on this list that has a work assignment, there'll be a 1. And then if I go up to my data tab and select my filters, I can drop down the filter and I can see that there are some that say hashtag NA, which means they're missing that work assignment. So I'm going to deselect number 1 because I just want to look at those hashtag NAs. And so this is going to be the list of all the employees who were missing the work assignment. So that's a quick way of using XLOOKUP to identify those 29 missing employees. And as we can see, if we highlight column B, look down at the count, it does say 30, but we know that they're also counting the header value. So minus 1 is 29. These are our list of 29 employees who we need to load those work assignments. Now let's look at the next example. In this example, we've got two different employee demographic reports that we ran on two different dates. And we want to look at the newer report and find out if there's been any salary changes. Now, if we know that the structure of the data is exactly the same on both reports, then we can just compare the two salary columns. So we could insert a column on the new report, go over and copy. Control C to copy, come over here, right click, and paste. And that will add the old salary information. So I'm going to update the header. And then I'm going to create a new column by inserting, and then we're going to use an if formula to compare these two values. So I'm going to type equals if, and then open parentheses. And the logical test is going to be if f equals g, then we want this to say no change. So we'll open quotes and say no change, close quotes. Then the next test is comma. If that value is false or if that statement is not true, then we want that to say change. So we'll say open quotes, changed, close quotes, and close parentheses and hit enter. So then all we have to do is select that cell with the formula, copy it down, and then we can filter this. We'll call this the change column. And we can filter this by the value changed, and we can see that this is the list of employees whose salary has changed. Now, this formula, of course, will work if we know that our salary structure, the data structure of the two reports is exactly the same, but it could be different. We might have new employees on the newer list or might have terminations, so that list may not be exactly the same. So in that case, we're going to use conditional formatting instead of the if formula to highlight the differences between the two. So let me go ahead and clear my filters. We're going to delete these two columns that we created. So we'll start from scratch. So in this scenario, what we want to do is automatically highlight any values on this newer report from what's changed, and we're going to be comparing it to the old report. So I'm going to click on the tab that has my new report, and I'm going to drag over all the cells, then I'm going to hit Control Shift down arrow. It will select all of the data area that I want to use. I'm going to come up to my Home tab, click on Conditional Formatting, and click on New Rule. Then I'm going to click on Use a Formula to determine which cells to format. And then I'm going to type equals, and I'm going to select the first cell in my report here. So cell A1. And then I'm going to use my two brackets to say if it doesn't equal, and then I'm going to navigate over and select this cell, then we want that to populate. Now we want to remove the dollar signs so that this range will be dynamic. So I'm going to put my cursor, I'm going to hit function F4. It might just be F4 on your keyboard, but if you hit that 3 times, it will remove the dollar signs around that cell reference. So we're going to do the same thing, put our cursor around that one and hit function F4 or F4 on your keyboard 3 times to remove those dollar signs. Now this is going to recognize of the selected data if something doesn't match on that other tab or that other report. And so what I want to do is have it highlight the cells. So we're going to click on Format, we're going to go to the Fill tab, and then click on our highlight color that we want to stand out, and click OK, and then click OK. And so now on our new report, we're going to see highlighted values for anything that has changed. So we can see that a couple job titles have changed and a couple of salaries. So now what we can do is come up to our filter, and then we can actually filter by color, and we can select the fill color, and this will be our list of employees who have had a salary change between the times that we ran these two reports. Now, in the last example, I'm going to show you how to detect duplicates in your data. So on this last example, we have a list of job codes that we're cleaning up. And notice that some of my job codes have letters in front of them, and I want to get rid of those letters. But if I get rid of those letters, I want to make sure that the number, the 5-digit code left behind, isn't a duplicate, because I don't want to have redundant data. I might need to create a new job code for those. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to select my data. I'm going to come up to Data, click on Sort, and we're going to sort by job code. And then that's going to put everything that has a number down at the bottom of my list. So what I want to do is create a new column and remove that letter. So I'm going to click on column C, right click and hit insert, and then we're going to call this new job code. I'm going to change that color. And I'm going to type equals, and we're going to say write, open parentheses, We're going to select that cell, and then we're going to hit comma, and then put the number of characters. And we want the 5-digit number of characters in our job code. Hit close parentheses and enter. Now, that's just going to give us our same value that we have over here in column B, but when we copy it down, notice when we go to the bottom of our list that it does remove that letter in front of all of those other codes. So that's the new code that we want to use, but we want to make sure there's no duplicates. So while I have that column highlighted, I'm going to hit Control C to copy, and I'm going to hit Control Shift V to paste the values. And so now I've got my new job code all squared away. So now I'm going to select that column. We're going to come up to Conditional Formatting on the Home tab. And then we're going to go to Highlight Cells Rules. And then we're going to go down to Duplicate Values. And we can select here what format we want to have those highlighted cells or those duplicated cells highlighted in. It defaults to a light red fill with dark red text, and that's fine. You can drop down and change that if you want to. And I'm going to click OK. So this is going to highlight those cells, and now we can come back up to our filter, and then we can filter by color. And it asks us if we want to filter by the cell color or a font color. So you can do that, either one. We're going to select that, and then it will show us here all of our duplicate values. So anything that is duplicated here, we know we need to create a new job code for. There are a lot of ways to bump files in Excel, so be sure and leave me a comment below and let me know your favorite way of doing this. Be sure and subscribe to my channel for more tutorials like this, and you can visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com, for more resources. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.